having my breathtaking beauty captured for the Evening Standard. Colour supplement, darling.
Really? So am I. My appointment's at 1 o'clock.
What a hideous coincidence, man.
You don't suppose they want to shoot us together?
A grim portrait of two hag-faced relics in the ruins of the club Taboo.
The Ebergenius Queen's Dragon here. Oh, no, touch that filthy
potential there.
Are we going to be interviewed as well?
Well, I hope so. Nobody's ever asked me to tell my side of the story. All those fabulous freaks. Those magical nights.
Well, they're not. They're all gone now. No point in dwelling on the past. Even though the price of a pint of beer is doubled, the world now is a better place.
No, Sue, no. Our world was better. We were better, we were pretty, we were popular, people liked us.
One more, make it a job. been raised by wolves.
George O'Dowd came from a place called Eltham in southeast London.
Oh, sure.
Must be so disgusting and factual.
A figure emerged from the mist!
In my memory, it's always a mist. A very heavy fog. Does wonders to your reflection.
And the shrimp.
Education was never quite part of my life.
everyone else.
I believe you've succeeded,
my friend. Any ambitions?
Besides stopping traffic.
I'm going to be a famous singer. Yeah?
I'm going to drive past my old school in a limousine and wave.
Like Queen Elizabeth.
I'm going to be famous in places that I've never been to. Like America or Outer Mongolia. My mum says I'll get nowhere like this.
Have you ever heard of Jean Cocteau?
Oh, why has he got a band?
No.
Well, that's an artistic domain.
He said, cultivate whatever it is that people condemn you for. Because that is what is truly original of man is in.
And what makes you the great expert on fame and fortune?
I've been around.
I've been many, many women can see.
You clean the toilet!
Funny. People trust me. They go where I tell them.
Clubs need cool people, freaks to mingle with those who pay.
I have a kind of, plain paper of lost souls. I can try and get you a job at my club. Planets.
Planets?
Oh. And what could I do here? You can work in the coat check.
You stick your fingers to yourself, dear boy.
My name isn't Boy. He's George.
All right, boy. George.
Oh, come on! Are you allowed to take credit for giving George's stage name?
Shut up, Stuart, make it look theatre.
Listen to me. I've got some masochistic friends who will put you up here for at least a few weeks. No need to thank me. It's nice talking to you, new dear. Who are these people?
The usual mix of intellectuals, drag queens, hoods, and thieves. Don't worry.
Yeah. shit, are you gonna let me in or not, sir?
Then let's be serious for a moment. Would you let you in?
Straight through. Listen, write down your address, dear. I'm doing some events. Very dressy, very mad, and very repulsive.
You're fitting perfectly.
Hello. Do I know you?
I'm in your mind.
Oh,
you don't remember me.
Your crown's nose, darling. Oh, I know. Oh, my God.
Come back next
week. It'll be so much more fun for you.
But you said that last time.
Oh, well, very busy. Maybe if you wait. I've got a bunch of things. Ah, I've been your tester.
You look as though your entire world's come to an end.
Who won't let me in again?
Oh, well, that's ridiculous. You look divine. What's your name?
Nicola. You'll be soon.
Can't deny it.
No, but everyone knows who you are.
Sounds ominous. Here, I'll get you in. Now, where'd you find those glasses?
I made them.
Oh, you're an artist.
I'm not sure. Look at the part of an artist. I'm looking for the other half.
Our friend Lee's got to see you.
Lee Bowery. Don't introduce me. He's a genius.
Yeah, that's one word for it. Come on. Stand aside, Philip. Us ladies need a drink.
You know the little match girl?
She's Russian nobility, Fleabag.
Takes one to know why the Princess Susan get an ugly bitch.
Now allow me to meet my friend, the Grand Duchess Nicola wanting to piss off. Come on, we need watering.
No, she's running down the hallway. feeling you know, they've done something long enough, eventually people just give up their good truth and surrender.
Get to work, dear. Can you check your coat?
Do we hang out with your high and mighty friends who barely say a word to me?
Do we have to discuss this here?
You're a photographer?
Yeah.
The camera's a bit of a giveaway. Do you do fashion?
Oh, do you work for any magazines?
I shoot mostly portraits. I should take your picture.
I've never seen anyone like you.
That was a compliment, right?
Be careful with that coat. I've heard about things being stolen.
Forget about the code. I worry about your boyfriend.
So? Will you pay the photographers then?
There's loads.
Must we do this now?
I love Hampton's pictures. Joe's so stylish. And David Bowie. Well, the 60s stuff. And Brass Eye.
Bye. came all the way here, Kelton.
I'm afraid I'm the only inhabitant. But I will carry you. You and all the other most grotesque images from my darkest imagination.
I've rarely been so placid.
It's like an addiction. Whenever I see you, I always want more.
More? Let's be one less of me.
It's not enough to see you pose. I want to see you perform. Singing and dancing and blading.
What am I to do with you? Here I took you to some timid little mouse. I suspect I'm to do all that get up your borderline psychotic.
Well, that's true, but perhaps I could be with someone else.
Hey! I'm not even flushed down the toilet! Oh, hello! Have you met Nicola? Isn't she fantastic?
Beyond! That outfit shouldn't work.
That's all!
I'm doing it myself!
Yes, so you can take a tip from her.
Oh, I think I'll pass. Now, look, David is about to leave. He's the rate for you at the bar.
David is David.
David! Your future assistant! The one who's going to bring you to the next level?
He can bring me a vodka and tonic if he fancies.
Go out and meet him. He'd cut patterns and do tailoring.
I can cut patterns.
He'll help you reach a wider audience and make good money.
I'm not interested in mass production. Mine's pure couture. I'm my favourite only customer.
No one else can carry it off. Your body's part of the design.
Spot on, dear. Spot on. Look, sir, work at the own pace. I'm not organised enough to have an assistant.
David, I hope you get organised.
My lead work is exquisite.
You need someone to help you make the next big step.
I don't see it.
Try him out.
In
1 week.
Whatever you go through soon.
Oh, just do it.
All right, Sue, I'll get an assistant.
Well, now you're acting sensible.
Nicola, you got yourself a job, gorgeous.
What?
Give my way for afternoon, bringing tea and biscuits, a large jar of sundried flowers, and then you can get that right green.
It already is!
Bring it.
something.
Yeah.
What is your name?
Marcus.
No, your real name.
That is my real name.
Out with it.
Gary.
Marcus is no more artistic. Yours. George.
Hello.
I do have a friend who calls me Boy George.
No! Did you see? Did you see?
My head says run away. Why don't you trust me? There's nothing to fear. No one will hurt you. What I'm here.
Excuse me, wanna get out of these ridiculous clothes?
Muck from around my eyes. I don't know why I bother sometimes. Paint my face up for a kill. A little bit of glitter goes a long, long way. If you never see my face, how will you know if what you feel is real? I'll never be, but I'm nothing special. There's no mystery. I've been hiding from the world, from myself, wanting love so desperately.
Nothing. You're putting on more makeup.
No, I'm not.
You are.
right away. You think I'll scream if I see what you really are?
Not my rival.
And it's like,
then?
An anti-aging cream.
Do you use it?
I use the entire line.
Well, to be, it doesn't fucking work then, yeah. It won't be long before the universe catches on. You've got the figure,
you've got the voice, yeah.
Basics you stuff, we fought for choice.
I can see your styles from the girl I know.
Now he's moving.
moving from fashion into performance, and I think he'd be great.
Oh, please leave Barry to loose gang. He's legally his own controllable, too.
I thought you were
wise
about that, eh? Then he'll be all yours.
It's not that. I believe in him.
You get me my point. And leave the headlines for look.
My God! You sound like you're making a pact with the devil!
No, but far worse. The devil's fag hag.
And they sit
here and far worse, the devil's fag hag. Scribble it and I got you. So, I got the permit. And in my search for bands to play for, I met these really great guys who lost their lead singer. Where did he go? All about you, George. And they only gagged a little bit, and they want to get together with you right away.
What? Philip, that's not going to work. I've already got a band, you see.
Hey, what kind of band? Another band for your hair?
John, that's really, I'm trying to talk to you.
I'm trying to write a song. I've been working with these guys for a couple of months now. We might record a demo for Virgin.
A demo? Are you ready?
Well, this isn't some crazy wing. I've been planning this all my life. I just don't like to talk about things unless I know something's really gonna happen.
You're angry, aren't you?
Yeah,
I'm not angry, I'm thrilled for you. You're practically imploding with good cheer.
What about this then?
Why doesn't your band play at the ball? Darling, I will get you a great spot.
No, no, we've got a gig that night.
We're playing Croc's nightclub.
I wish you could be in both places, but really know how it is.
Yeah.
I know how it is.
And I told him, wish you could be in both places, but you know how it is. Well, this is gonna happen.
Yeah.
I don't have any.
Look, thanks to you, aren't you?
Yeah.
Wants to be the only person in your life. Write a new song.
Try.
Can have a look?
No.
Come on, Marcus, go away. Get off me! No, I haven't finished it yet. Ow! Marcus! I haven't finished the last little bit yet.
It's about me, isn't it?
Of course. He's a love song.
Does everyone need to know our business?
Well, we are lovers, aren't we? I mean, never actually said that to me.
That's all right, though.
I can't explain.
you go out and have sex with any man you can get your hands on.
Yeah, but I don't wake up with them, do I?
I don't understand.
Who can explain the attraction? You're nothing special to me.
Sounds like you're saying he rather than she. You will never get a record contract singing the song that way.
He's just trying to scare you, George. Listen to me. You sing the song the way you want to. It'll come out.
Right, let's do the other one then.
Come on, you criticise me for pulling back and playing it safe. What do you think you're doing, huh?
What? Look at me, Marcus. Look at my face. I'm like Joan Collins with Welsh scrub. Am I pulling back? Look, I have just got to get past the starting line, all right?
Okay, I'm ready.
I think you are.
If you're going to do that horrible one about me, they're all about you.
Is this my function in your life? To be fun up in your tragic love songs?
Well, I can't help it. I find your deeply flawed character endlessly fascinating.
At least it's one way for you to get famous.
You are this close.
Oh, yeah, back.
What is going on in there?
Nothing. Look, this is my big chance. If you really want to help me, just go out and give me some tea, yeah? And don't be long.
Yeah, well, we want this new material.
Don't. Just go, Billy. You're not helping.
Go on, go.
Oh. Bye. course it had a harpoon in it.
Yeah.
Vivian Westwood brooch. Broken in your fucked up slop ears. It's irreplaceable. But you're not.
What?
Beep!
Or even better, why don't you and me go away on holiday?
joint of music in each of him.
You just don't get it, do you?
Fucking stronger than this grass. Marcus!
Thank you.
your own man's world of fans, managers, producers, lawyers, press agents, promoters, and reporters.
Not tacky. Call somebody. Welcome to the club. Mm.
Queen's today to announce that our friendship is officially over. Don't call me when you find the you-know-what.
George, I need to ask you a favor. I told them I could get you to do an interview with McCartney.
Oh, yes! I found him! Oh, I forgot to up in here. Now that was clever, me.
So, Carolyn. Jesus, George.
Marcus! Don't! It could be worse. Not using needles, am I?
Yeah. Well, I was doing okay with the freelancer, but this would be steady work. I hate being so dependent on you. I think maybe I should get a place of my own. I've got a career now. Job's lined up.
Really?
Well, I can't take watching you destroy yourself. You see when you look in the mirror. Can't you disgust me?
How dare you judge me? I might know what you see in the mirror. But some great success. You have no career, and I know all about the magazine job because I got it for you. Mm-hmm. Every job you've ever had was given to you as a personal favor from me. All I have the bloody well paid for mine. You're a mediocre talent!
Let me go bad! Oh, you're just mediocre!
Why are you doing this to me? Stop asking them any fucking questions! How long did it take to do your makeup? All will then will be.
Shut up, George!
I am sick of the sound of my own voice! I can't still have everybody's life! Oh. If I wanted to be a career counsellor, I wouldn't have escorted 15 now, would I? Oh, what, Gary? What more can I do for you?
There was a time when I believed that you could change the world for me. I woke up and the pain was gone. I found the strength to carry on. Twisted my reality and all my possibilities. Now look at you, all broken too. And now we're moving on.
Conscious.
I don't want people to cotton on to my ideas. I certainly don't dress like Mr. Gershaw. Can you imagine the next time I go into Marks and Spencer's, all the women will be bald with ink dripping from their hair? It started when I
thank you.
know. Scary. Hold your hand.
Stop it, you're acting like Sue.
Maybe Sue was right.
Are there people out there?
Some. Please, they. What would be like for St. Mary's?
If my audience is out there, St. Mary herself can be bloody well liked.
Ich bin cool. Can't you see? Look at you, and look at me.
Let me describe for you a scene of infinite betrayal. A certain young man enters the newspaper office. That makes an offer. That was a surprise to everyone. Not to me.
I really don't have time. I thought I needed to shut up about to go to press. What's this all about?
I'm a close personal friend of Boy George. I've got a story for you with the Lottery newspaper.
And I know it's true.
I've got pictures. I'm a photographer.
This could mean a lot of money for you.
I don't want anything.
Then why are you doing this?
You wouldn't understand.
As reported in today's Sun, pop star Boy George is hopelessly addicted to heroin. The star was unavailable for comment. George, hold your head up. Come on, George. Stay with me. We go live in 10 minutes.
I look like I've been dragged up from the Titanic.
I'm doing the best I can under difficult circumstances.
Now, come in. Billy! Get off me! I want to talk to my friend.
We don't have much time!
Yeah, well, I've been doing my own makeup, you know.
That may need a makeup contest. You need a more Egyptian.
Charming. I was afraid you might have it tough, my love. Anyway.
It's good to see ya.
I can't talk much because I'm back in the mute. Look at it. Don't you think you've had rather enough press lately, Tim?
Oh.
It's been all the headlines about my upcoming tragic death from drugs.
Am I going to lose you?
You miss me?
I just don't want you to die before you introduce me to Barbra Streisand.
I really thought this would be different.
Just thought of it. I must tell you, George, you look like shit.
But it's a look.
Oh, I've got to get ready. You know, I'm supposed to prove I'm not one step from the grave.
Maybe you shouldn't go on.
What? Cancel a live TV interview?
You're not completely out of mind.
Not think. I'm alright.
Anyway, I've bought something for you.
No, I was going to give it to you. Pride of a fallen star and all.
It's my Vivian Westwood brooch. These are diamonds. I'm sorry I'm going to kill them. Left the car. It's a place.
Come on. I can't believe you want to be a diamond!
I'll be
at the notes, George. They're going fast. It's quite an achievement for a pop star, don't you think? Going back from sports into action. They even invented a special new charge for George. Fast possession. Which sounds rather poetic, doesn't it?
You're not obliged to say anything, but anything you do say might take it down at your arch and give it an evidence.
Why don't you tell someone who cares?
Mr. Boy George, I hope you realize you have a criminal record.
Yeah. I'm a comedian.
Well, take this down! It was no secret that it was Marcus who first sold the stories of the Sun. I was determined to find that bargain still with Judas.
Hey, Gary! Where are your famous girlfriend, eh? Is he in the bush?
Look, I was just around to take pictures, that's all.
Yeah, right. We've got a picture. Here, give us a bit more shape, darling.
Oi! You think of those beers we got 30 pieces of silver?
So, you're going for the mature ladies now, eh, Gary?
I don't think much of your size. What do you think they need a brain for that?
Philip, what?
I don't care who you sleep with. You're a social climber and a fake. I saw through you from the start. I'm so jealous of George. You changed your quiver and even that wasn't enough. You're so foul. You're so loathsome. You're a sniveling, addictive, no-talent whore! No, I see that. You give Rawls a bad name.
Well, there's a name for you, mate, and it's faggot!
Yeah, and I'll share it with your buddy right here.
Come on, faggot!
All right, you know. Oh, look, he's in the bottom. He likes you, Jerry.
Oh, no. Get off me! Get off me! I'll have you kill one of me. Get off me! Get off me!
You didn't take the money.
Get off me, mate. Let's get off it.
Shit! Oh, shit!
Inside, are you full of pride? Or
Nicola. I asked you to tell anyone else in hospital.
I think she should be here. I asked her to come.
Soon. Oh, God, if you two are talking. I must really be ready for the golden
I thought you'd be all wasted away. You haven't lost a single pound.
Nor have you.
I'll leave you two alone.
So Nicky called you then?
Yeah. I must say it was big of the little woman. You missed me?
No. Come on, Mr. You still got those hideous orange curtains in the room.
Yeah, Lee, the one you made me. I heard Lucian Freud's painting of you. It's going to be on display at the National Portrait Gallery. You should be very proud.
Why must my greatest contribution be to someone else than you? 2 more years, that's all I need. And now it'll be famous.
I never understood why fate was such an obsession with you.
You can't understand. You're the least ambitious person I've ever known.
My only ambition was to be your best friend.
You did good, sir. Anything for me.
Nicola! You need something?
You two are the only people I want here. When I die, I want you to spread the word that I've gone to Papua New Guinea to open an Angus.
How are we going to pull that off?
Get some postcards and I'll sign them. I'm not going to be famous as a meat victim. Don't let that be my legacy. Promise me that.
Promise.
I promise.
Besides, I like the idea of you two exploring together.
Please, Liz, stop it.
What a triumph, mate. What a supreme triumph. London's most notorious open section was unconditionally loved by 2 remarkable women.
LEIGH BOWERY died on New Year's Eve. His wife, Nicola, was by his side.
Mother clutches thy head, mother dying son. Anger and tears
India. I just got back. It's meant to be on my poker ticket at 1 o'clock. And wasn't with you two gargoyles, was it? You look good.
You look well.
You look alive. I suppose you've had enlightenment and there's still been holy waters. One of the lessons you learn in India is to stop talking, turn listening. No Swami speak to us.
Give us the answer to life's riddles.
You should always have a good pair of shoes and a comfortable bed. Because if you're not in one, you are in the other.
That's it.
Yeah, surprisingly that was.
My pleasure here.
Don't touch me. Oceans of tears, raindrops are red. So much to laugh about, so much you wish you could forget.